I know that I'll be a mess. Second that I see you, but you won't be surprised. It happens every time. It's nothing new.
It's always on a night like tonight. I thank God you can read my mind.
Cause when you look at me with those eyes,
every time you walk into the
they know you want pictures, so I'd be happy to share those with you when they get them. Please refrain from taking any pictures to share them. So on behalf of Brooke and Alex and Chloe, I'd like to thank all of you for making the journey and taking the time to be here. Brooke and Alex have invited you here to Algonquin Park to show you a glimpse of an important piece of their love, to share with you the beautiful lakes, beaches, and trails that they've explored, and where they've created countless memories during their 9 years together. By your presence, you celebrate with them the love they have discovered in each other, and you support their decision to commit themselves to each other for the rest of their lives.
That's a nice view.
On this day of celebration, Brooke and Alex would like to take a moment to remember Brooke's grandmother, Ruth, and Alex's dad, George, who, although are no longer with us, are most certainly here today in spirit. And it seems as though George may have been the first one to give his blessings to this marriage. On Alex's 19th birthday, 3 days before he passed, when Alex and Brooke were visiting him at the hospital, he grabbed their hands and said, "When are you going to marry this girl, Alex?" To which Alex responded, "Dad, I'm only 19. I'm too young to think about it." And George said, "She's the one. You're going to marry her one day." As we join Brooke and Alex in marriage, we celebrate them as they begin a new family together. Yet we also know that this branch of the family tree will be strengthened and enriched by the love, traditions, and knowledge of their family roots. Will you, Barbara, Mary Lou, and James, offer your blessings to this union will you celebrate them in their times of joy and bolster them in their marriage in times of hardship?
We do.
We do.
Today, the relationship changes. We all know it will grow and become stronger and better. Today, Alex and Brooke demonstrate their commitment, mutual respect, love, and faith in one another. You who have all gathered here today as witnesses are called to continue your support and encouragement as a united marriage. Marriage is more than two people standing up here repeating vows. There's an art to any creative activity, and so too in marriage. Part of the art of marriage is finding room for things of the Spirit. So continue in your search for the good and the beautiful in some. Part of the art of marriage is being flexible. So in your marriage, cultivate flexibility, patience, understanding, and a great sense of humor. Part of the art of marriage is to comfort one another and strive to be each other's best friend. And most importantly, develop the capacity to forgive and heal differences made. Always remember that your love will prevail. It will be the miracle that invites you to learn, to blossom, to expand your horizons. From your new marriage relationship will come the nurture and strength you both need to face the world. Only from this moment on, you'll face the world together in a new way. But today, a new feeling is born in our world will be the better for its growth. And for this, we all celebrate. Alex, you've chosen Brooke to be your wife. Will you love and respect her? Will you be honest with her always? Or will you stand by her through whatever may come? Will you always love and respect her?
Faith. The definition of fate is the development of events beyond a person's control. And these uncontrollable events would eventually unfold when I ran into you at a friend's house and you were crying your eyes out. I asked why, and you replied, my boyfriend just broke up with me. Even though you were clearly upset, I couldn't have been happier. I don't think I will ever forget that summer. It was filled with so much excitement and happiness. I craved to be in your presence and soon realized how compatible we really were. I honestly feel like there was no better time. My dad passed away. I was surrounded by family and friends that would be there to help me with anything I needed. All I wanted to do was be with you.
Oh.
You're the one that helped me through. It wasn't easy, but you stuck by my side. You raised me up when I was feeling low. You never gave up on me, and I'm forever grateful for that. You have definitely not had the easiest life. Diagnosed with a giant cell tumor at age 16, had it been a very scary time for you and your family. Not to mention the 16 surgeries of following. The strength you have is undeniable. You're a brave, strong-willed woman. You're an inspiration to many people, but most of all, you're an inspiration to me. Coming home to you and Chloe every day is the best gift a man can ask for. Brought her into this world for us, and I couldn't be happier that she is able to be here today to witness her parents share this moment. You're an amazing mother. And I can't thank you enough for everything you do for us. I really don't think I could have found a better life partner than you standing up here with me. People say marriage isn't easy. It takes hard work, communication, honesty, and respect. I vow to be a better man every day that we're together. I vow to make you happy and you're so happy. I vow to keep you and I'm always protected for as long as I can live. And above all, I vow to treat you with the utmost respect and reserve. Time waits for no one. It will always keep you. And in the end, all I want is our time together to last. So taking it slow, enjoying little things, and living life to the fullest is all I need to do now. I will always make time for you. I never want to lose you, bro. You are the glue that holds us together. You are my rock, my soulmate, and my best friend. I will never stop loving you, plus loving you for as long as I shall live.
Alexander George Gautreaux. I've always believed what's meant to be will be. Our lives have crossed paths too many times to be considered coincidence. It seems as though it was inevitable, meant to be. We've always had an indescribable connection. And hey, you're pretty easy on the eyes, so it makes it easy. It seems like just yesterday we were two 17-year-old kids who fell in love. And here we are today, about to become husband and wife. For 9 years, you've not only been my love, but my best friend. You've helped me through some of my most challenging moments in my life and have shared some of the greatest moments in my life. One of which being our beautiful daughter, Chloe. I swear I fell in love all over again, watching you become a father. I am so grateful for how hard you worked to support our family. And I know your father would be so proud of the man you've become and the man you're yet to be. We often take for granted the very things that we deserve, that deserve the most gratitude. I know I'm not always the best at expressing my love for you, but I want you to know there's many things I love about you. I love that you have always made me a priority in your life, many times putting my needs before your own. I love how humble and how patient you are. I love that you can always put a smile on my face. Even if sometimes you drive me up the wall. I love that you are always down for an adventure. I love that I feel safe with you and that I can trust you with everything. I also love that you kill all the spiders for me, but I can go without you chasing me around with them first. I love that I feel comfortable to be my true self around you and that you love me for me. Above all, I love you for who you are, for who you were and who you've yet to become. As your wife, I promise to help you be your best self, to encourage, support, and challenge you. I promise to give you the best of myself and not to take you for granted. I promise to listen with an open mind and an open heart. I promise to make time for you, to keep our lives exciting, adventurous, and full of passion. I promise to persevere when times get tough, knowing that any challenges we might face, we will conquer together. I promise to remember that neither one of us is perfect, but will strive to remind myself of the ways that we are perfect for one another. Wherever our journey leads us, I promise to love you for worse or for better, from now until forever. Alex, I couldn't imagine my life without you. I'm so happy we get to share the rest of our lives together as husband and wife.
Forever, babe. I love you so much. It's okay. All right, may we have the ring?
crook, I give you the fruit.
That you may wear it.
That you may wear it.
As a symbol of her vows.
As a symbol of the vows.
We have made this
day. We have made this day.
I pledge you my love and respect.
I pledge you my love and respect.
My laughter and my tears.
My laughter and my tears.
To guard and protect.
To guard and protect.
All that you hold dear to your heart.
All that you hold dear to your heart.
That I am.
All that I am.
These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love for you, that you are holding on your wedding day as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that we work alongside yours as together you build your future. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief fills your mind. These are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and tears of joy. These are the hands that will tenderly hold your children. And these are the hands that will help you to hold your family as well. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it. Lastly, these are the hands that even when wrinkled and aged, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness. May the love which has brought you together continue to grow and enrich your lives. May you meet with courage the problems which arise to challenge you. And may your relationship always be one of love and trust. May the happiness you share today be with you always. And may every word you have pledged here be living truth in your lives. So if Mary Lou and Barbara would like to join us, we're going to sign the documents.
If it's gonna be just us, if we're gonna ride together, turn two to one, gotta make it work. I'm not saying it's easy, sometimes we get hurt. I promise I ain't leaving, yeah. It's gonna be a couple fights, just to see who's wrong or right. If it's love, we both know what it's gonna take.
To share your lives in marriage. We recognize and respect the covenant of marriage you have made before each one of us as witnesses today. In the honesty and sincerity of what you've said and done, it's my honor and delight to declare you to be husband and wife.
Thank you.